So now that we understand what the discrete probability distribution is, let's start doing some calculations, some basic calculations. The first thing we want to take a look at is the mean of a discrete probability distribution. Then, of course, we'll look at the variance and standard deviation. The mean for a discrete probability distribution, mu, is equal to the sum, I equals 1 to capital N. This capital N is the population size of the x size times the probability x equals x size. So the x size could be individual observations. And then this is the probability of actually observing that specific observation. This is really just a weighted average. So what it's doing is taking each observation and weighting it by its probability. And then this is saying add them all up. Now, the idea behind that is obviously that outcomes with higher probabilities will have a heavier weight to it, so it has more influence on the final outcome. So let's take a look at this for this coin toss example. Let's write this distribution out again. We had H, the probability of the random variable capital H equals this little h. There's 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. That was all of our possibilities. This was 1 out of 16. This was 4 out of 16. This was 6 out of 16. This was 4 out of 16. And this was 1 out of 16. Now notice here that this distribution is actually symmetric. Not all discrete distributions are going to be symmetric. Matter of fact, in the next chapter we looked at the binomial. The only way it's going to be symmetric is if the probability of success is a half. But we'll come to that in a little while. Most discrete probability distributions that you will run into in the real world won't have symmetry like this. And that's an important note. I'll come back to the idea in just a second. So what we need to do is figure out what the mean is going to be. Well, I'll rewrite this. The mean is equal to the sum. I equals 1, 2, there's 5 possible outcomes. Of the xi times the probability x equals xi. Okay, so this first outcome, xi, x1, the very first one happens to be 0. And actually I could change these to h's. This is the generic way. If we actually want to use our random variable, then we should change these to H's. And that might make it a little bit easier for you to grasp what's going on. I'm not sure. I will, just for sake of conversation here, I'm going to make this HI. This is H and HI. So the first one is a 0. So this would be 0 times the probability of getting a 0, which is 1/16. Plus, the next h is a 1, so it'd be 1 times the probability of observing a 1, which is 4/16. And then the next one is a 2 times the probability of observing a 2, which is 6/16. Plus, the next one is a 3 times the probability of observing a 3, which is 4/16. Plus the last one is a 4 times the probability of observing a 4, which is 1/16. So now I need to add these together. This is going to be 0 plus 1 times 4/16 is 4/16. Plus 2 times 6, that's 12/16. Plus 3 times 4, that's another 12/16 plus 4/16, which is equal to 32/16, which is equal to 2. So the mean is 2, and notice that 2 is right here, so right smack down the middle, because this is symmetric. If these probabilities were not symmetric, you would not get the guy in the middle. See, if I did this as just a straight average, take 0 plus 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4. And there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 numbers here divided by 5. That is going to be 10 over 5, which is 2. So now you're thinking, well, why didn't we just do that? Well, in this case, it would have worked again because of this symmetry. But just for conversation, let's mess with this just a little bit. Let's just pretend here for a moment that this was, let's change this one. Let's change this one and make this one 1/16, which is obviously false. It's not true. But let's just pretend like it was. And then I took away 3 here, so I need to add 3 up here. So let's just make this 4/16. So let's go back and see what it does to this calculation. This would be 4/16. This would stay the same. This would stay the same. This would become 3 times 1/16. This would stay the same. So down here, I'll still have 0. I'll still have 4/16. I'll still have 12/16. But this would then be 3/16. And of course, this is 4/16. So I get, when I add all this up, is 23/16. Which with rounding is about 1.4375. But see, I didn't change any of these. If I would have used the old technique, I would have once again come up with 2, which would have been wrong because the actual average is the 1.4375. See, by simply adding up the possible outcomes divided by the number of outcomes, we completely ignored the probabilities. Once again, the reason that they came out the same the first time I did it was because of this symmetry. If you do this with craps, if you look at the distribution for craps, it's also symmetric. It'd be the same with just simply adding up all the possibilities and divided by the number of possibilities, and you get the right answer. But that, again, is only because the probability distribution happened to be symmetric.